I just built a new release of my package image flip, and now I will share my new feature. If you are a user from the package image flip, there are some changes that might be interesting for you. First of all, I changed the command line, and I changed the entry points for the command line. You can use Python and then specify the model name. There are two options, first image flip.cle, like the old one, or the new one only image flip. And I also use the entry point option from the setup script to make a command line application that you can enter directly from your command line. So you can simply type image flip and that's it. I also change the look of the command line interface. These are the new features for the user from the package. But I also improve the source code, I add some tests, and I change the structure. There was nothing special, so I speed it up. If you're really interested, look in the source code of GitHub. The link to the source is in the video description. So, first of all, I change the structure of the project, add some new files to make it easy to grab all the functions from the API in one place. And for the final result, I get an URL with an image where you can download it. To make it easier, I build a class which holds the URL and add some extra functions. For now, it's only the function for open in the web browser, but a new function will be to save the image to your local hard disk. And I add also a second class, it's the client class for the API. It only grabs the functions from the API and also add a root URL and hold everything together, like the username, password, and holds the list with the memes with the templates. Let's make it easier to play with the API. The basic idea was for my test case, but that was not a quite good idea, so I just try it and I failed and I go for the classic way. My idea was to build a test case, and for this test case I will run a local web server which has some fake data for the API, and then I would change the root URL in the client class to the localhost, and then the test case runs against the localhost and get all the data from my local web server. But it was really painful to get the web server running, and the multi-thread was also, it was not that easy, but I accept. And I came to one point where I was spending too much time to get this working, that I decided to go the classic way. And the classic, the old school way, maybe the right way, I probably think it's the right way, is to use the monk package from the, yes, use the monk package. To explain it, make it short, the monk package fix some results from other package. For me, it's the results from the request package, from request get and request post package. And on this point, I change the result from the real web server to some fake data I storage on my, or inside my test case. And yeah, it's worked quite well. There you see, I just add some dictionary, which which is the fake result. Later I just save it inside a file, and with the monk class I load it when the test case is running. And as you see, I get also some errors. There was some real errors. There was some case I forgot to make. It was a case I forgot, so I have to fix it. And you see, it's quite, every package, every comment packet has some test case, which makes easy for other people to make sure that it's running. And I also use the coverage package to look how much of my source code are executed by the test case. Let's make it easy to find some source code that's not executed by the test case, and so you can think which missing for the test. So that was all the stuff in the backend. It's not that important for the user. So to make something new, I add a new command line interface where you can use some option to set some values for the user, for the password, for the index of the image, and so on. If you skip one of the option inside the command line, the program will ask you to enter it. So you can you can enter the username in the command line, but not the password. That's quite obvious. If you write a script to execute this program, you maybe want to write your password, but I wouldn't show it in the video, so that must be an option. Yeah, and that's it. You have for the command line to put two sub parser, one for the list of all templates, there's nothing, no option for it, and the other to make in the caption. Yeah, I know I can just improve it a little bit, but for now I'm okay with this, and I think it was time to share the result. Yeah, that's all. I hope you like it. Write a comment if you have any questions. If you want to see more videos from me, please subscribe my channel, and we see you next time.